Today we are discussing about biliary colic. It is also known as gallbladder attack. Let us say Angela has gallstone in the gallbladder and she ate delicious burger for lunch. As the burger enters the duodenum, the cells of the duodenum are stimulated to release a hormone called as cholecystokinin or CCK. If we were to break the name, the word cholecysto refers to the gallbladder and its associated ducts, therefore the hormone cholecystokinin acts on the gallbladder by stimulating the gallbladder to contract to release bile. Bile is a lipid emulsifier, meaning that it breaks lipid particles into small droplets. Why it does that? The reason is to enable the enzyme lipase to efficiently act on those droplets. Without emulsification, lipase is unable to efficiently digest lipid. Let us go back to Angela. We already knew that she has a gallstone in her gallbladder. Because of this, when her gallbladder contracts, the gallstone gets expelled from the gallbladder and gets deposited in the cystic duct or the common bile duct, creating an obstruction. These stones irritate the duct lining and cause pain. The pain is usually referred to the right shoulder. The phrase colic refers to a patient's regular postprandial pain, which comes and goes. A severe gripping or gnawing pain in the right upper quadrant is the most common symptom of biliary colic. It could radiate through the back or around the lower ribs or even to the epigastrium. Some people may also experience nausea and vomiting. Biliary colic patients are often afebrile and will not typically have any abnormal vital signs, unlike acute cholecystitis or cholangitis, which may present with fevers, tachycardia, or even hypotension if they develop to septic shock. On physical examination, patients with biliary colic typically only experience right upper quadrant or epigastric tenderness. Less frequently seen are abdominal distension and rebound tenderness. When the cystic duct is blocked, jaundice is not observed. If there is jaundice, consider other diagnoses as well. The famous mnemonic for risk factors to be remembered is the 4F, which is female, 40, fat and fertile. However, according to a study published in PubMed, the F, which stands for 40, should be replaced by familial history in recognition of role of incidence and changing demographics of gallstone disease. The preferred investigation is abdominal ultrasound. Depending on patient and the attending doctor's preference, liver function test and full blood count may be ordered. It is crucial to divide the treatment modalities to definitive and symptomatic. Symptomatic treatment like low-fat diet, pain medication, and antiemetics can be prescribed. In a reasonable amount of time, the patient can be followed up with for an outpatient laparoscopic cholecystectomy after receiving these treatments. However, if the patient exhibit more severe pain and several other symptoms of shock, hospitalization and more urgent surgical care are necessary for symptomatic alleviation. Definitive management is surgical removal of the gallbladder or cholecystectomy. Let us quickly recap the essential points. Biliary colic occurs when the gallbladder is contracting against an obstruction like a gallstone. A severe gripping or gnawing pain in the right upper quadrant is the most common symptom of biliary colic. It could radiate through the back or around the lower ribs or even to the epigastrium. On physical examination, patients with biliary colic typically only experience right upper quadrant or epigastric tenderness. The risk factors to be remembered are 4F, which is female, familial history, fat and fertile. The preferred investigation is abdominal ultrasound. Symptomatic treatment like low-fat diet, pain medication, and antiemetics can be prescribed if patient is having mild pain and can tolerate it. Definitive management is surgical removal of the gallbladder or cholecystectomy.